Hello, I'm from Lalbagh Girls Inter College. Today I'm going to tell you something about the election and the democracy. As you all know that India is the largest democracy in the world. Have you wondered what this really means? Abraham Lincoln defined democracy as a government of the people, by the people, for the people. This means that in a democracy, it is the people who actually run the government. Now, how do we elect our president and our prime minister? And who are the voters? Qualification of a voter. Any citizen of India whose minimum age is 18, resident of the city, enrolled in the voter list can vote and elect our government. Now, who are the contestants whom we are going to choose as a government? So the qualification of these contestants are their minimum age should be 25 years of age, they should be Indian citizen, and they should be resident in the city. So the members elect a chairperson and a vice person. The chairperson preside over the meetings there that are held at regular intervals. In his absence, the vice chairperson performs the function of the chairperson. There are some permanent office like executive office, education officers, secretary, health officer, sanitary inspector, municipal engineer, and junior engineers, etc. So these are the qualification for the voters and of the contestant for whom we are going to vote. The next thing is the Election Commission of India. The main body in charge of conducting elections in India is the Election Commission of India. It is headed by the Chief Election Officer. The Commission is in charge of making sure that elections are conducted in a free and fair manner. So these are the election process, the candidates, their qualification and the voter qualification. How do we elect our government?